Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Lebrake. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received at Sakhir Palace His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa and the BDF Commander-in-Chief Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa. His Majesty the King conferred upon His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and BDF Commander-in-Chief the Prince Salman bin Hamad Medal for Medical Merit in appreciation for their honorable role and efforts in combating the coronavirus pandemic, which was reflected on the Kingdom's good reputation and the international appreciation and commendations it received. His Majesty wished His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister and the BDF Commander-in-Chief success in serving their country and people. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa today received a telephone call from His Majesty King Abdullah II ibn al-Hussein of Jordan. His Majesty King Abdullah II extended his congratulations to His Majesty the King on Bahrain's glorious national days, wishing him abundant health and happiness, as well as further progress and prosperity to Bahrain and its people under His Majesty the King's leadership. His Majesty King Hamad expressed thanks and appreciation to the Jordanian monarch for his noble feelings towards Bahrain and its people, which embodies the strength of the fraternal relations between the two kingdoms, wishing the brotherly Jordanian people further progress and prosperity. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received in the presence of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa at Sakhir Palace the members of the Royal Family Council to greet His Majesty the King. They congratulated His Majesty on the National Day celebrations in commemoration of the establishment of the modern Bahraini state as an Arab and Muslim state founded by Ahmed Al Fatih in 1783 and the anniversary of His Majesty the King's accession to the throne. They expressed pride in the kingdom's achievements in all fields, which gave it a high status among world countries as a result of the wise leadership of His Majesty the King and his righteous approach. They expressed pride in His Majesty's efforts aimed at developing relations with various countries and establishing its honorable stances in world events, as well as enhancing its leading role in the Arab and international areas. They wished His Majesty the King abundant health and happiness to continue leading the development march in Bahrain during his prosperous era. His Majesty the King welcomed the guests and exchanged congratulations with them, expressing thanks and appreciation for their noble national sentiments. His Majesty affirmed that Bahrain will continue its growth and development with confident and optimistic steps towards the future to continue the success of its march and progress, increasing its achievements and maintaining its civilizational gains. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received the Representatives Council Speaker Fawzia Zainal and the Shura Chairman Ali Al Saleh in Sakhir Palace in the presence of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, where the guests expressed congratulations on the Kingdom's national days in commemoration of the establishment of the modern Bahraini state as an Arab and Muslim state founded by Ahmed Al Fatih in 1783 and the anniversary of His Majesty the King's accession to the throne. They prayed for His Majesty's ongoing health and happiness, and the people of Bahrain for their prosperity, development, and well-being. They praised the kingdom's achievements under His Majesty's leadership in all fields, which raised the profile of the kingdom internationally. His Majesty exchanged greetings with the guests and thanked them for their efforts in serving the country and its citizens. He affirmed pride in the important role of the legislative authority in developing the national efforts and enhancing the democratic process to serve the aspirations of the citizens. His Majesty praised the productive cooperation between the two authorities towards further development and prosperity and praised the efforts of the people in serving the kingdom and preserving its achievements. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa patronized the National Day celebration at Sakhir Palace in the presence of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa in commemoration of the establishment of the modern Bahraini state as an Arab and Muslim state founded by Ahmed Al Fatih in 1783 and the anniversary of His Majesty the King's accession to the throne. At the beginning of the celebration, the national anthem was played and 21 shots were fired.
الرحيم. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه، سيدي صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد رئيس مجلس الوزراء حفظه الله ورعاه، أصحاب السمو أصحاب المعالي والسعادة، أيها السيدات والسادة، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته، وكل عام وأنتم بخير. خير ما نبدأ به تلاوة عطرة من القرآن الكريم يتلوها على مسامعنا القارئ علي صلاح عمر.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فما أوتيتم من شيء فمتاع الحياة الدنيا وما عند الله خير وأبقى للذين آمنوا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. والذين يجتنبون كبائر الإثم والفواحش وإذا ما غضبوا هم يغفرون. والذين استجابوا لربهم وأقاموا الصلاة وأمرهم شورى بينهم ومما رزقناهم ينفقون. والذين إذا أصابهم البغي هم ينتصرون. وجزاء سيئة سيئة مثلها فمن عفا وأصلح فأجره على الله إنه لا يحب الظالمين. ولمن انتصر بعد ظلمه فأولئك ما عليهم من سبيل. إنما السبيل على الذين يظلمون الناس ويبغون في الأرض بغير الحق أولئك لهم عذاب أليم. ولمن صبر وغفر إن ذلك لمن عزم الأمور. صدق الله العظيم.
بارك.
الكلمة السامية لسيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أصحاب السمو والمعالي والسعادة الحضور الكريم، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. نرحب بجمعكم الطيب أجمل ترحيب، ويسعدنا أن نتوجه للجميع بخالص التهاني في ذكرى أعياد الوطن المجيدة، داعين الله سبحانه أن يعيد على أسرتنا البحرينية الواحدة بمزيد من الرخاء والطمأنينة والتقدم تحت لواء الدولة الوطنية التي تشكل كيانها العربي الإسلامي قبل أكثر من قرنين من الزمان، وحفلت عهودها على مر عصورها بالبناء الحضاري وبالتقدم الإنساني القائم على مد جسور السلام وإرساء الأمن والاستقرار، والذي حفظ أفضل جوانب ما يميزنا دون إخلال بالحقوق التاريخية والقانونية الثابتة لمملكتنا العريقة. الحضور الكريم في هذا اليوم المبارك يحدون الفخر بأن نكون دولة وشعبا يدا بيد، ونحن نؤدي أمانة العمل والإنتاج، وأمانة الوفاء والولاء، وأمانة المسؤولية والخدمة العامة، وأمانة التعاون والتكاتف، لنؤدي للبحرين الغالية حقها وواجب خدمتها. وما أجدرنا هذا العام ونحن نمضي قدما بروح التجديد لفريق البحرين الواحد أن نخصص هذا الحفل المبارك للاحتفاء بأداء وعطاء كوادرنا الوطنية على الصفوف الأمامية، ومنحهم وسام الأمير سلمان بن حمد للاستحقاق الطبي نظير خدماتهم المميزة وإسهاماتهم الجليلة في مواجهة الجائحة المستجدة بظروفها الصحية الطارئة، وهم الدفعة الأولى ضمن كوادرنا المتميزة، إذ يبقى الكثيرون ممن سنحرص على تكريمهم فيما هو قادم من مناسبات. ولا يسعنا هنا إلا أن نتوجه لهم جميعاً ببالغ التقدير والاعتزاز لعطائهم ومواقفهم المشرفة، ولما بذلوه من جهود جبارة وتضحيات عظيمة للعبور بالوطن إلى بر الأمان. ولا يفوتنا كذلك في مقدمة هذا التكريم أن نخص صاحب السمو الملكي ولي العهد الأمين ورئيس مجلس الوزراء الموقر بامتناننا العميق لجهوده الكبيرة طوال هذه الفترة الحرجة، والذي حرص خلالها على متابعة دقائق الأمور وبمعالجة هادئة وحكيمة نشكره عليها ونهنئه على نتائجها المرموقة ونظرته الاستباقية في كل ظرف. وختاماً نبارك لكم جميعاً هذا الأداء الباهر، ونكرر الشكر لتكاتف الجميع من أجل البحرين في مثل هذه الأوقات الاستثنائية التي عمت العالم. ولا يفوتنا كذلك أن نعرب للجميع عن تقديرنا واعتزازنا بما تلقيناه من مشاعر الإخلاص ومواقف التأييد والولاء في هذه المناسبة الغالية، وكل عام والبحرين وأهلها الكرام بخير ورفعة وأمن واطمئنان، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Then His Majesty bestowed the Prince Salman bin Hamad for medical merit on his recipients.
في الحفاظ على صحة المواطنين والمقيمين والعمل ليلا ونهارا بروح الفريق الواحد، حتى أصبحت مملكة البحرين محل إشادة في المجتمع الدولي. فقد وصل عدد من شارك في خدمة الوطن من مختصين وفرق طبية ومتطوعين من أبناء البحرين الأوفياء إلى 15,811 شخصاً. يتفضل سيدي جلالة الملك بمنح الوسام. سمو الشيخ محمد بن مبارك آل خليفة نائب رئيس مجلس الوزراء. سمو الشيخ علي بن خليفة آل خليفة نائب رئيس مجلس الوزراء. الفريق أول ركن سمو الشيخ محمد بن عيسى بن سلمان آل خليفة رئيس الحرس الوطني. سمو الشيخ عبد الله بن حمد آل خليفة الممثل الشخصي لحضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك المفدى. سمو الشيخ ناصر بن حمد آل خليفة مستشار الأمن الوطني قائد الحرس الملكي. معالي الشيخ خالد بن أحمد بن سلمان آل خليفة وزير الديوان الملكي. سمو الشيخ خالد بن حمد آل خليفة قائد قوة الحرس الملكي الخاصة. سمو الشيخ عيسى بن سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة. سمو الشيخ محمد بن سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المفدى، حفظكم الله ورعاكم. سيدي صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد رئيس مجلس الوزراء، حفظكم الله. أصحاب السمو والمعالي والسعادة، السادة الحضور الكرام.
Then the Undersecretary of Research and Projects at the Office of the Prime Minister, the head of the Operations Room to Combat the Coronavirus, Hamad Yaqub Al-Mahmid, in which he greeted His Majesty the King, His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister, and the guests. He expressed pride for celebrating the national days in the presence of His Majesty and appreciation in His Majesty's confidence. He said that there have been many achievements in His Majesty's era and that the honoring of distinguished citizens represents an incentive for further development and excellence to raise the kingdom's profile internationally in all fields. Al-Mahmid also expressed his pride in the frontline workers who have been inspired by His Majesty's determination to contain the pandemic and who have been led by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince. He concluded by extending thanks and appreciation to His Majesty on behalf of all of the honorees and further congratulated His Majesty on the occasion. It is noteworthy that the Prince Salman bin Hamad Medal for Medical Merit was conferred upon 15,811 frontline workers and those with support in various fields in appreciation for their sacrifice across all phases of the pandemic to protect the health and safety of all.
من الكوادر الطبية وقوة دفاع البحرين ووزارة الداخلية والعاملين في غرفة العمليات والمتطوعين والجهات المساندة الذين يستلهمون دوماً من جلالتكم أيدكم الله العزم والإرادة، وتشرفون بأن يكونوا ركناً أصيلاً في الجهود الوطنية التي يقودها سيدي صاحب السمو الملكي ولي العهد رئيس مجلس الوزراء حفظه الله، بروح تحب التحدي وتعشق الإنجاز، والتي دفعتنا جميعاً لنرقى إلى هذه المسؤولية العظيمة ونتجاوز بها كل التحديات الكبيرة والليالي الطويلة الشاقة التي تهون أمام شرف خدمة هذا الوطن المعطاء، معاهدين جلالتكم على بذل الغالي والنفيس من أجل وطننا تحت قيادة جلالتكم الحكيمة. مليكنا المفدى، تقف كلمات الشكر عاجزة عن وصف مشاعرنا تجاه هذا التكريم العظيم. وختاماً، أرفع إلى مقام جلالتكم السامي بالإصالة عن نفسي وبالنيابة عن جميع المكرمين أسمى آيات الشكر والتقدير والامتنان، مهنئين جلالتكم بهذه المناسبة المباركة عادها الله على جلالتكم سنين عديدة باليمن والبركات. حفظكم الله قائداً وبانياً لنهضة الوطن وإدامكم ذخراً للبلاد. حفظ الله البحرين بكم وحفظكم للبحرين، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
The Kingdom of Bahrain is celebrating its national days in commemoration of the establishment of the modern Bahraini state as an Arab and Muslim state founded by Ahmed al-Fatih in 1783 and the anniversary of His Majesty the King's accession to the throne. The celebrations are taking place at a time of achievements by the kingdom on all levels. The streets and buildings of the kingdom have been decorated with the colors of the flag amid the celebrations of citizens and residents. من أقرب شعور الروح لأقصى من النظر حييت في عيون أحضنتك وغمضت أجفانها حييت أبو سلمان يا سمح المحيا والفكر حييت The representative of His Majesty the King for Humanitarian Work and Youth Affairs, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, deputized the first Deputy President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, the SCYS, President of the General Sports Authority, the GSA, and President of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, to attend the final match of the Boys Secondary School Football Championship 2021-2022, organized by the Ministry of Education in cooperation with the SCYS, the GSA and Bahrain Football Association. His Highness Sheikh Khalid witnessed the final match between the teams of Al-Fatih School and Al-Ta'awun School, which ended up with the victory of Al-Ta'awun School, whose team His Highness Sheikh Khalid has crowned. On this occasion, His Highness Sheikh Khalid affirmed that developing school sports is part of the outcomes of the Istijaba program, which His Highness Sheikh Nasser has launched to develop the sports system. His Highness asserted that the GSA began its first steps of implementing the plans that will develop school sports through enhancing the partnership with the Ministry of Education. He hailed the efforts of the ministry led by Dr. Majid Naimi in implementing programs that develop school sports. Nazan Sheikh Khalid congratulated the president and members of the educational authority of Al-Ta'awun School on the victory, commending the high technical level the team has demonstrated during the championships competitions, which reflected the team's preparations, competitive spirit, and high concentration in all matches. For his part, the Director General of School Affairs at the Ministry of Education, Dr. Muhammad Mbarak bin Ahmed, congratulated His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al-Khalifa and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al-Khalifa on the National Day, expressing pride on His Highness Sheikh Khalid's attendance of the final match, which demonstrates His Highness's support to school sports. The General Secretaries of the Representatives and Shura Councils held National Day celebrations with the attendance of the Speaker Fawzia Zainal and the Shura Chairman Ali As-Saleh in commemoration of the establishment of the modern Bahraini state as an Arab and Muslim state founded by Ahmed al-Fatih in 1783 and the anniversary of His Majesty the King's accession to the throne. The event was attended by the members of the two councils where poetry was recited and the council guards were honored on Bahrain Police Day.
اشتكى احد صدره بالمحبه يدور.
حمد انا المنظوره حمد
براكب نور.
حمد اوابن الصدر حمد
بالمحبه يدور. حمد ساعدنا حمد وعدنا حمد املنا بين الحشا.
A number of ambassadors of friendly countries to Bahrain congratulated His Majesty the King on the National Day. They highlighted the deep-rooted relations between their countries and Bahrain and the development they witness in all fields.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. As British Ambassador to Bahrain, I am delighted to offer my greetings to His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa and the leadership of Bahrain and the people of Bahrain on the occasion of their National Day. I think after another difficult year, the National Day is an occasion to come together, to celebrate, and to look forward with confidence to what I hope will be a more prosperous next year, and a year in which we are behind all of the health challenges that we've had in this last year. I think it's a very exciting time of year. The embassy is opened up again. We are doing events. Collaborating with our Bahraini friends in so many fields, in education, in security, in commerce, and we're really excited. So best wishes to everyone on the occasion of the National Day. Thank you. Take care, everyone.
We value our long-standing bilateral relationship and thank His Majesty the King and His Royal Highness Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa for their continued commitment to our historic and still growing strategic partnership. The United States appreciates our unwavering bond and shared security commitment, including through Bahrain's hosting of the U.S. Naval Forces Central Command and U.S. Fifth Fleet. We value our outstanding economic cooperation and the U.S.-Bahrain Free Trade Agreement, which has helped trade grow an astounding 300% since its implementation in 2006. And we're proud of our expanding people-to-people ties that grow yearly through our cultural and educational exchanges. As in the past, the United States and Bahrain will continue to build on our historic relationship by advancing cooperation across all areas.
I want to extend all my congratulations to His Majesty the King, to His Royal Highness, the Crown Prince, Prime Minister, to the Bahraini authorities, and to all the people of Bahrain on the occasion of the Kingdom's National Day. So much has been done. So many achievements have been made since the establishment of the modern Bahrain state and since the accession to the throne of His Majesty the King. France has always been a reliable partner of Bahrain, and we are proud of this. You can be sure it will continue in the future.
On the occasion of the National Day of the Kingdom of Bahrain, it gives me great pleasure to extend heartfelt congratulations and best wishes to His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa and to His Royal Highness Crown Prince Prime Minister Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. The relationship between Germany and Bahrain is excellent. Next year, we will celebrate 50 years of diplomatic relations between Bahrain and Germany. And in this occasion, the occasion of the National Day, I want to extend all my best wishes to Bahrain and its good people for more prosperity and progress.